Hi, so today I'm building a Carl Goldberg Eagle 2 wing, and this is the last kit that I have to build, believe it or not. I've built a lot of kits over the years and a lot of scratch built planes also, but this is the last kit that I have to build. So I want to just go through building the wing. That's what's left here. And I'll show you a few tips along the way. So I've taped down a piece of 3/4 inch foam, and that's my building surface on my flat table. And then laid out the plans, taped them tightly down to the foam. And then I usually use wax paper, but I went to my wife's wax paper drawer and found out we were out of wax paper, so I just put saran wrap down for now, but I prefer wax paper. So I've already cut out all the ribs and sanded the shape on all the same numbered ribs. So they're all the same, and so we'll just lay them out where they go. This is the center section, so that's rib number one. These are both number two ribs, where the sheeting goes. There's a number three rib. It's short because of the plywood brace on the trailing edge, and then the rest of these are number four ribs. I'm just going to set them out here so they're ready to glue in place. Also, I've got the bottom spar pinned down to the building board. It's pinned down with pins that crisscross in a few locations along this bottom spar. So we'll get started with one little tip. If you need something to either mix epoxy or something to put glue in, this is just the bottom of a pop can cut off and turned upside down, and then you use this part of the can for mixing or putting glue in. I'm using Type Bond 3 because I build a lot of seaplanes, and Type Bond 3 is waterproof. So I'll put some of the Type Bond in the bottom of this pop can, and I just like to use that. It's easier than using the bottle. Sometimes you get too much glue if you use the bottle, and then I usually use a Q-tip to dip in the glue and apply the glue with the Q-tip. So it says not to pin the trailing edge down yet, and actually some of the sheeting won't be glued down yet either. I'm just gonna put it under here as a spacer. It says to use scrap wood, but I'm just gonna use the bottom sheeting. Try not to get glue on it. So we'll put this first number four rib in at the beginning, get our spacing correct. Make sure that we use a reference point to line everything up. I'm using the outer wingtip edge to line everything up. And so I'm gonna test fit it just to make sure that it fits in there fine. Okay, that looks good. So we'll just glue that in place. put some glue on the tip trailing edge of the rib. And in this notch where the bottom spar goes. And we'll just place it right there on the pan. Got a rag in my lap and I can put excess glue on. First one, I want to make sure that the ends are correct length. I'm just going to stick a pin in the foam here at the end just to make sure it doesn't move on me. And I'll make sure this one goes in square. Okay. That's looking good. And check it this way also. Okay, so in also. That way if the plans aren't exactly perfect, then we can get that spacing correct. Sometimes the plans will vary a little bit with humidity or temperature or whatever. So I'm sliding this rib slightly to the right of the actual spot that's shown on the plan. This one's lined up perfectly over the line, but this one, I'm using the notches in the trailing edge, so it doesn't come out exactly right, so I'm just gonna just move it so that it's parallel. And then I'm gonna pin this trailing edge down here. Use this square to push so I don't, oops, I just bent the pin a little. I think it went in, maybe not. That trailing edge is pretty hard balsa. Try that again. Put a pin in down this direction also. All just using the square right now as a kind of like a thimble so I don't puncture a hole in my thumb while I'm pushing the pins in. I'm just using regular sewing pins, straight pins. I'm gonna get this, make sure this is straight, so. They're the first ribs. Get those started. And I think I'll put this trailing edge or the tip rib on also. This is a thicker rib. It's an 1/8 inch instead of the rest of them are all 1/16. This one pinned to the trailing edge. So those are all started. Go get this number 3 when it's. Actually, I think I'm gonna use CA on this one so it stays in place better. There's no slot for this because it's plywood on the trailing edge. Okay. So we've got those four ribs installed. Looks like that one's gonna need to be pinned so it doesn't come up on me. So I think we'll put one of these in the middle. I'll use CA on this one also. So that should get us kind of locked into the dimensions that we need. Just take a peek at the instruction to see if I'm sure I'm doing it right here. So it's telling me not to glue these first three ribs in yet until the sheeting is down. It says to start gluing the leading edge here at the center section, and then we do the sheeting. So I just want to check and make sure I get the leading edge at the right spot on the tip, and I think I'll CA this in place here. So double check that. Okay, so put a pin in front of the leading edge to keep it against the rib. And it says not to glue it here yet, but I think I will put a pin down at this end, even though it's not glued to the wingtip area yet. But just hold it in place there. And then we're supposed to do the sheeting, so the bottom sheeting from the leading edge. Let's see how close we are. Looks pretty Good. Could be a little tight. I think I'll just sand this edge just a little bit where it meets the dowel. And by the way, these Durablocks are really nice. Use the self-adhesive sandpaper that sticks right to them. And you can get these at automotive stores, or there's lots of places that sell Durablocks. I've got several different ones, and I mark the sandpaper that I'm grit that I have on there. They even have long skinny blocks, and I think I have a round, like a dowel one also. So you can get a set with lots of different blocks, even these smaller ones also. And they're not that bad cost-wise. Okay, so I'll put some glue along this leading edge here. And also where it meets the spar. Get rid of some of this extra cotton that's hanging down on the Q-tip. So we got the front leading edge sheeting done. See how the back looks. That's gonna be long, so that's fine. This is 320. So I'm gonna attach these two sheets together, so just use a piece of masking tape about the length of the seam. Usually I do this on a sheet of glass with some wax paper, but just do it on the... I'm pressing the sheets together as I'm taping, and then I can just put some glue in that seam. Excess off, and then you can sand where that seam is, and that sanding dust can goes into that seam area. Looks like I need a new piece of sandpaper in there. Okay, that's about done. Use that on the inside. Not sure. So now I can see. I'll sand this edge. Put that up against there. I can mark where this needs to be cut. Okay, looks like my battery died, so I missed part of the wing construction, but we'll just continue from here. And what I want to do next is glue the top spar in. So I think all I missed was gluing a few ribs and gluing the leading edge dowel onto all the ribs. And I added some rubber bands to keep the dowel tight against all the ribs in a few places. So we're gonna glue the top spar in, and there's a gauge. There's actually three different gauges depending on which wing you're building. And I'm building the B wing, so it has less dihedral in the wing and ailerons. So use this gauge to figure out how far to set back the top spar. And that makes it easier to sand that dihedral in. So let's put some glue on the ribs and then we'll put this top spar in. Just go to all these notches. Put some glue on all these notches. This Type Bond 3 glue works well for this, so it doesn't dry too quickly before everything's gets inserted into all the slots in the ribs. Okay, so hold this gauge here. Butt the end up to the gauge and then insert the spar, top spar, into all the slots. See if I can tape this end down to keep it tight and slide a piece of tape under the bottom spar. Push it down, stretch the tape up tight. Pull this pin out so it's not in our way. Do the same on this end. Sheeting was glued down, it might have stuck to the saran wrap a little bit. Okay. Give that a try. weight that I'll put on the spar. Looks like it's down. All right. So our next thing we need to do is glue in the compression spars. Sorry, the shear webs. So shear webs go between the top and the bottom spar, and the grain goes vertically on the shear webs, and they're already pre-cut in this kit, so glue these in place. Well, it looks like I need to take some of these pins out. Interfere with these. Glue need to clean up here. Okay. Now few of these clamps that'll probably work. I think these are too small. Yeah, those are too small. I have a few clothespin clamps that could work. Down. So some of these bays are thinner. I'll just do the ones that are this width first. Okay, we just have a few things left on this half of the wing. I've got some of the shear webs installed, and so I have just a few more at the wingtip and a couple of gussets to put in, and that's about all we can do on this half of the wing. Then we can do the exact same to the other half. So let me get these glued in. They go on both sides of the spars near the center of the wing, but out at the wing tip they just go on the front side of the spar. Last shear web. Oh. Thank you. these gussets glue into the corners at the wingtip. Okay, so one half of the wing done. Okay, so all the shear webs are glued in to the right wing half, so that completes the right wing half, and now we can get started on the left wing half. So with the magic of video and the snap of my fingers, we have the left wing completed. So the next thing we want to do is join the right and the left wing halves together at the center section. So I'm going to use some masking tape just to keep that seam together until we get it glued. So just tape the center section sheeting. So it stays in place there. These two halves. Sheeting down to the tape that's already underneath. And we count over the fourth rib, 1, 2, 3, 4, and prop this up to the correct dihedral. Which this is the B wing. You can build a AB or C wing. This one is the B wing with ailerons and low dihedral. So I think before I lift it up to that angle, I'm gonna glue this joint. Weight off temporarily while I glue the. I need to lift the wing in the center and get glue into the joint, center joint. So now, at these plywood dihedral braces, I've already modified the angle for the B wing, which is a lower dihedral. So I had to cut the angle a little different on these braces so that they'll fit in inside the center section. So I have two braces here. And I'm going to use tight bond on these also. Okay, you get these clamps that come along. You can use that to clamp the braces in place. Until they dry. Okay. That dry, and then we can start doing the top sheeting. And there are a few other things that need to be done. I'm going to do a bolt-on wing, so I'm going to add some balsa into the trailing edge and also work on the a dowel in the front to attach it to the fuselage. So, we'll let this dry and then we'll be back. Okay, so here's the completed wing. Eagle 2 wing. Normally it's, I think, 63-inch wingspan. This one's 66. I didn't have the plastic wingtips that normally come in the kit, so I made these wingtips out of balsa wood, and they're a little bit bigger than the stock plastic wingtips. I put LEDs along the front in front of the spar, so I'll plug it in so you can see what that looks like. Blue LEDs. I'll turn this light out so you can see how it looks. So yeah, there we go. We've got the wing complete.